You know, this afternoon, on the record, I want to thank you all on behalf of the Fiji Rugby Union Board and the CEO and the staff of Fiji Rugby Union, and also all the rugby supporters in the country for your presence here this afternoon. The appointment of offline Fijian coach has been a lengthy process. As I know, majority of you have waited anxiously for this announcement. You all have a copy of the media release that's been put together by Fiji Rugby Union, and also certain quotes from certain comments from our coach, whom we've appointed to take up the post as our Flying Fijians head coach. Before I go into taking questions and answers this afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, we just want to show you a short clip from our new head coach, Mr. Vern Cotter.
I'm really excited about getting this position with the Fijian Rugby Union as head coach of the Flying Fijians. I've been really impressed with the people I've dealt with up till now, and we all know the talent there is within Fiji and the good work that's been done up until now. I'm really looking forward to working with the people that have been integral in bringing Fijian rugby forward at all grades, players, coaches and administration. I've been lucky enough to coach several Fijian players during my career in France, and I really appreciate what they bring naturally to the game. The likes of Nemanja Nololo, Jimmy Nagusa, Napoleon Inanaga, and Sivivatu, who was an All Black. Myself and other coaches will be working to bring additional skill sets to make Fiji as competitive as possible in the world rugby scene. And we really want to enjoy our rugby and our time together.
Ladies and gentlemen, just before we take any questions, like I said earlier, the process has been a lengthy one, and I understand that the majority of all Fijians have been waiting anxiously for the announcement of our Flying Fijians head coach. In summary, there were 20 candidates that applied for the post. We've shortlisted it down to six, and the sixth shortlisted candidates went through the process, and we've come up with the best candidate for the job, whom the panel believed and the board endorsed to become the next Flying Fijian coach. And as you heard from the clip, Mr. Vern Cotter from New Zealand, who's currently the coach, I've been director of coaching up in Montpellier in France. You know, Luke, we're happy to take any questions.
Mr. Chairman, Mr. Potter's contract with Montpellier will end in June, so will he have an early release, or when is it expected to start?
Vern was supposed to be in Fiji for this media conference. Unfortunately, he has to travel back to France to meet up with his current employers and to discuss his appointment as our Flying Fijian coach. Whether he's going to join us early or as of June, that is something that we will await the outcomes of his discussions with his club up in France.
Mr. Chairman, does this mean he's he will take us to the next World Cup?
Ideally, that's the solution that we want, but the contract that we've given to Vern is for 3 years, and hopefully there will be a review in the second year to gauge his performance and to see whether this will need to continue further.
I noticed that Mr. Potter will be working with some local coaches for their rights, and he said on development and succession planning. So is there a hinting that there is a possibility of a local coach taking the position of the Flying Fijians coach?
What media organization you call?
Fijitech.
Pinavolu Fijitech. Thank you. You know, yes, that's one of the negotiations that we've been in with Mr. Potter, to have one of our locals under his tutelage during his term as our Flying Fijians head coach. The coach that earmarked to be under his guidance is Senirusi Seruwakulo. We want him to be under his tutelage during his tenure year. And at the end of the day, this is the vision that the Fiji Rugby Union has, the board has, that one day, and hopefully we foresee that coming after the Rugby World Cup in 2023, to have a coach, a local coach, that can take us onwards to the World Cup in 2027 and beyond.
And guess this was to add on to Chairman, one of his key roles is to work also with provincial coaches, upskill them and bring them up. And we have a lot of coaches within Rugby House. We've got Sari Paul, it's a good opportunity having a top quality coach who's coached at international level to upskill our coaches, yeah? And mentor them into future roles for the A-teams, PGA teams. Yeah?
Is there is this the first time we have a director of rugby as a national coach?
Thank you, Aquila. As you can see from the prepared media statement, you know, it's in the appointment of Mr. Van Cotter, a world-class rugby coach. If you read through the media release, his experience up in New Zealand rugby, particularly with the Crusaders, and then on to clubs in France like Clermont and also Montpellier, and also being head coach of Scotland, I think it augurs well for the future of Fiji rugby. It's an investment for Fiji rugby, and I think Fiji rugby has been very fortunate to secure the services of a top world-class coach like Mr. Van Cotter.
About his coaching team, like will he make up his own coaching team or will be with the help of Fiji Rugby Union?
Thank you, Irfan. What we've done is we normally leave the appointment of his assistants and technical coaches and support staff to the coach. But like we said, Seni Rusi, that was part of the negotiations in securing Van Cotter's decision to come and coach the Flying Fijians, to have a local under his tutelage during the period of his employment with Fiji Rugby Union.
I guess that's the next step in his appointment. When he comes and resumes his duty, he will then indicate to us what his preference are, and then we have to look at our budget and things, and that's a matter for me and when to get down into business to make sure that he has a team that supports him, that will support our competitiveness.
Just to go back to Fiji Times earlier question, if I may, I know there's a lot of interest on developing local talent. I want to, you know, pose the question back to the media, you the experts in this. The capacity, you know, right now we're trying to build capacity in Fiji Rugby Union. We lack in that area, particularly in areas of coaching, to be coaches up in the level 2, level 3 area. That's somewhere that, that's something that we're driving towards with the help of Oceania Rugby and World Rugby. On Thursday, you'll also be invited to another media conference. You'll also be making an announcement for our General Manager High Performance Unit. I'm glad to announce to the media gathered here this afternoon, you know, it's also going to be another Fiji that's taking up this post, and also earmarked, hopefully, after 2023, we have capacity in our ranks to be able to take up this appointment as a Flying Fijian coach, as Murua coach, as a Latui coach, to come and work as our manager development and also our operations team.
Just two questions on the operation coach. Will you be based in Fiji during the term?
Yes, part of the requirements and negotiations with Wood. As you know, the Sports Commission funds the salary of the head coach, and one of the requirements is that the head coach must leave the Fiji, the side of Fiji. That's a matter for when he comes for us to discuss his accommodation and things when he starts.
So anything on his package?
I think that we have good negotiations with Wern. But as a matter of confidentiality, we cannot discuss the package at the moment. But like I said, the Sports Commission helped us in the funding of the coaches package. We have consulted them before the appointment, and they are quite happy with the whatever package we get.
Mr. Chairman, sorry. Finally, for my, is there a possibility to release the 6 songs?
The candidates. Okay, thank you, Willa. The candidates for Mr. Dean Richards, many of us know him, former England number 8 player who's currently the director of coaching up in Newcastle in England. Also, Mr. Cedrus Iservakula, Frank Azima from France, Olivier Mene from France, and Simon Rewalui from Australia, but a Fijian living in Australia.
We are excited. We can't wait for him to come and start because we know that with his appointment, you know, the Flying Fijians will move from where we are now and to become more competitive against Tier 1 nations. And that's a target that we all wanted. We are excited, but I can't see the excitement in you guys. Are you excited or not?
Simon, Stanley's excited.
don't see the excitement in me.
Just to let you know, in a nutshell, ladies and gentlemen, you know, to become the best, you must also recruit the best, eh? So that's in a nutshell in how we went about this process. And we all hope and pray that, you know, Vern will come and deliver the goods for us when he starts.
Sorry, just one last question. What will be the first tournament that he will take the team to?
Well, depending on when he starts, like he said, we're looking at June. It's the PNC. That's happening in July. The test matches against Tonga, Samoa, and also against Australian Wallabies, eh?
Okay, guys. Thanks very much.
Sure. Anything about rugby? Sure. What do we have?
We
can report
the injuries in the
future, like you. In terms of the injury, Rachel in the and Sabu have returned. Will be returning home today. Rachel has got a muscle thing which might require 4 weeks of rest. Sabu has a knee injury which will require a surgery, but when he returns home, we will do an assessment on her injury to see, because if she undergoes surgery, then she misses the Olympics. We'll do an assessment and see whether there can be alternative rehabilitation program to get her fit to the Olympics. And Priscilla is flown out to replace the two players. No injury for the men, they all fit. We're waiting for Gareth to announce his tall men and also waiting for them to perform.
And there's another question.
CFL, any news about the coronavirus in Sydney right now? Do you have any contact about them? Anyone take it seriously?
I think right now it's something that you need to ask. Representatives that work up in the Australian High Commission, they would be the best people to advise us, and also those that work in the Ministry of Health.
Yeah, but the tournament is going ahead on Saturday and Sunday, so which means they have their precautionary measures. But tournament is going ahead.